Hey, John Hickok here. I want to show you guys my Lile Mission Knife from Rambo First Blood Part 2. Now, you've probably seen kind of the standard, look over here. So this is the officially licensed version, as they call it. Those are about $100. You can find those anywhere. They're all over the place. But a lot of you probably weren't aware that you can actually still buy a current production Lile made by the same company, started, of course, by Jimmy Lile, who died in the early 90s and designed the original Rambo knives. You can still buy from that company full quality, full movie quality Rambo knives. They sell both the Mission knife, which is the First Blood knife, which is what this one is, and also the First Blood 2 knife, and then the original one, right, which is pretty similar, but it has a green handle. The wrap is green and it has a slightly different blade. But this here is the Mission knife. So if you've seen Rambo Part 2, you should recognize that. I mean, just a beautiful knife. I mean, look at that. Look at the saw tooth there on the back. It's kind of like a double serrated saw tooth. Very cool. I mean, just a beautiful shine to it. And you know, anytime you have a knife or you see that Lile on there, you know that it's a very high quality knife. And now, even though this one is not one of the originals, which are basically almost unobtainable, as I record this video right now, there's a couple on eBay. One of them is like $10,000, the other one's like $12,000. I mean, they only made like a few hundred of them, I think. I mean, they're crazy valuable, crazy collectible, not obtainable for almost anyone unless you're a very wealthy knife collector. And these aren't cheap either. But it's not in that kind of ballpark, right? So it's cool that they still make these. And I didn't even know for a long time, just kind of figured out recently. And since I have an M60, I thought, well, I got to get the Rambo knife as well. And this one, see, it says 2020 on it there, which is kind of a cool year to have a Rambo knife have been made. And then, of course, it comes with this nice little case here and the microfiber Lile. You know, cloth there, and the sheath. It's all, you know, if you look at the photos and everything from the movie, it's all very, very accurate. You got the little sharpener there that comes out, just like in the movie. Really nice leather sheath. And then, of course, it wouldn't be a Rambo knife without the removable cap. Nope, lose it.
That'd be good.
It's got the compass in there. The only thing I've really noticed about this knife that is not 100% accurate to the movie is that the compass looks a little different to me in the movie, but it's basically the same. So I don't have anything hidden in there yet. So I actually, even though this knife is pretty expensive, I plan on using this thing, and I'm going to chop some stuff with it here a little bit later. It's because I love, you know, I'm a big kid. I love the Rambo movies. I love Bowie knives like this one. It's you know, and from what I've read, these, obviously it's a Lile, so it's very well made. And these knives are actually based on the knives that pilots would carry in Vietnam and World War II. They were a much more tame version than this. They looked a little bit like kind of like a K-bar, but some of them did have a serrated edge, and that's apparently where Jimmy Lile kind of got the idea and the inspiration. But obviously he wanted to make it something a little bit over the top for the movie and Hollywood and everything, and he really nailed it. I mean, such a beautiful knife. It looks great in the movie. And there's something neat about owning a legit Lile knife, even though it's not one of the originals made by Jimmy Lile, which if you own one of those, you have to keep it behind a glass case somewhere, you know. This one I feel like I can actually use, and I'm not destroying a piece of history because they are still made. So this one was made by Vaughn Neely, who is making the knives with Lile now, and it comes with this little certificate here. I'll show you. Check that out. It's his signature there. So super high quality knife. I mean, anything done by Lile is really quality work. A lot of people say that, you know, you might be worried, well, if, you know, it wasn't made by Lile, what's the point? But, you know, the people that took over after him are still making really good knives. And from what I understand, they might even be better than what was made before just by, you know, technology and all that kind of thing. And then I'm going to pull this one out and kind of show you a little bit of a comparison. Before I do that, make sure. All right, so let's pull out the cheaper one. So these run for like a little over $2,000. These are around $100. This is kind of just your standard, you know, it's the officially licensed Rambo knife. But as you can see, it's a different quality. You know, it's a little bit cornier. You know, it says Rambo all over it and everything. You know, which is fine. If you just want something to kind of symbolize your love for the movie, there's nothing wrong with this. It's a decent knife. You still got the sharpener there. You know, you can tell that the sheath is a different quality. You know, it's just not the same quality. Definitely a cheaper sheath. I mean, we're talking about it costs a tiny fraction, right? So obviously there couldn't cost somewhere. You know, and you can just, it's not as high grade of a steel. You know, they're using 440 stainless steel and it's like 420 something in this. I'm not a metallurgist, you know, so I don't know all the information about that, but this would do fine. I mean, this would be a fun knife to play with, and I've seen some stuff where people have actually used these and had luck with them not falling apart or anything like that. I mean, the one thing about these knives is it doesn't have a full tang, so you know, with this being a cheaper knife, you know, maybe you could run into some issues with it not being strong because of that. But I've also seen that, you know, there had not been a problem at all. So you still have the removable cap here. Now you notice it's a different color. So on the Lile knife, it's more accurate to the movie, where it's black aluminum instead of the with that no finish shiny. Move it here. Yeah, you've got a compass in there, a little bit different looking compass than in the original. And this one, actually, you have a bonus with the cheap one. If I can get it out, there it is. Which maybe I'll put this in my Lile knife, but you get the little survival kit. It's got matches and some different little things in there, so that's kind of cool. But I might put together my own kit to put in there. So this knife would be fine if, like I said, you just like the movie, you don't want to spend a lot of money hanging on the wall or something like that. But if you are a true fan and a Rambo nut, and you accept no imitators, and you have to have the real thing, but you don't have $10,000 to $15,000 sitting around to spend on a knife, this could be what you want right here. They do this one, and they also do the original knife. Well, like I said, it's a little different. It doesn't have the black. This one's a little more stealthy, right? The mission knife, because he was on a mission to go back and save the the Vietnam American POWs. So it's a little stealthier. The original one, it's got more shiny metal on it. It's, like I said, it's got the green wrap. But basically, they're the same knife. I mean, you got a 10-inch blade. Just a really cool knife. Let's chop some stuff with it, okay? Let's try to compare these two a little bit, see how they feel. I haven't used this yet. I wanted to save it for the video so you guys could see it in a really nice shape. Let's cut something. Let's see. Here we go. All right, you see this? So it's a pretty light knife, so you don't have a ton of force that you can come down with. That'd be one disadvantage of just this knife in general. Let's see how this one feels. This one, I believe, yeah, this one is noticeably even lighter than this one. Cut that same thing. See this, cameraman? Okay, so I mean, they both will cut okay. Let's walk over here, try something a little bigger. Follow me over here. Pretty good trail for you. Okay. So here's the Lile in my right hand. Alright. Now here's the officially licensed version, the cheaper one. So they both cut about the same. I can feel that I have to put a little bit more force. Oh, look at that. Okay, so this one, it's already loose. So yeah, based on that, this knife, not usable. Basically not a usable knife. It's a display knife. You know, I mean, this thing, it's a Lile, it's solid. So that's what you get with this. You get a Rambo knife you can actually use and not just hang on your wall. I mean, that's pretty disappointing right there, the fact that it came loose that fast. I mean, to the point where I don't even know if it'd be safe to even really chop with anymore. Let's try the saw here on this little tree. See how this works. I mean, it works pretty good. I mean, it's almost too small. Let's try it on this. And makes a nice little cut there. All right, so, hey, it's a real knife. You know, I mean, it's a pretty good little survival knife. It's The weight of it does take away from some of your chopping ability. If you had a big full tang Bowie, it'd be much easier to chop with. But again, the kind of the idea of this knife is it's a survival slash fighting knife. If you're Rambo, you know, it's a fighting knife. So you don't want anything that's too big and heavy and clunky. And having this size, this big blade is pretty cool. I mean, I would imagine you could, you know, skin an animal with this thing or whatever you got to do. So it's pretty cool. I'm glad that I picked this thing up, and even though it's pretty expensive, I'm going to use it. You know, it's just a neat little knife. You got the glass breaker also on the back there, and then there is a Phillips head screwdriver on the hilt, and then flathead on the other side. So it's a pretty practical little knife. All right, well, hope you guys enjoyed that. So just keep in mind, if you're planning on getting a knife to use, I don't recommend getting one of these just kind of standard $100 officially licensed versions, because there's so many other way better $100 knives you can get that would be actually pretty good. But if you want the real thing, check out the Liles. I mean, this is pretty cool. I mean, it's a bit pricey, but to be able to have a real Lile Rambo knife, you know, it's pretty special. So all right, I hope you guys got something out of that. Appreciate you for watching, and see you next time.
Fire.
It's a long walk from where I had to shoot that. Oh hey, didn't see you guys there. Since you're here, I want to let you know about our friends over at Talon Grips and Ballistol. talongungrips.com. check out everything they have over there. You can get lots of different grips, the stick-on grip textures for your handguns and rifle grips, so go check them out. Also, Ballistol, they're a firearms lubricant or anything else you might need lubricating. It's water soluble and non-toxic. Been using it on the compound and cleaning all of our guns. It's a cleaner and a lube for over 10 years. So Ballistol, Talon Grips, definitely check both of those companies out. And also, while you're on the internet, don't forget to go to Hickok45.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Hickok45, Twitter, Hickok45, Instagram, The Real Hickok45, and also I have an Instagram page where I post behind the scenes stuff and different things like that. John, J-O-H-N underscore H-I-C-K-O-K 45 on Instagram. And the next thing you have to do is watch more videos.